Good day, good afternoon, good evening. Yeah. Good day, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. I wish I hadn't bit my tongue so I could say that correctly. This is Viper AS for Viperland, and this is Song of the Deep. Game came out 10 minutes ago. My chat tipped me off, and while I've been looking forward to this game for a while, I didn't know the date it was supposed to come out. So here it is. We're going to do intermediate because I'm a pansy. Beginner is probably too easy. Advanced, I don't want to challenge right now. I just want to play the game. That's what's meant to be played. Mary loved the sea. She loved the sound wanted subtitles. The waves calling to her through her window. She dreamt every night of the mysteries that lay beneath.
Her father was a fisherman. Each day he went out to sea, and each night Merrin waited at the rocky cliff edge, holding up a candle to guide him safely home.
I'll turn on subtitles when I can.
Their roof was leaky, and they sometimes went hungry. But as long as they had each other, Merrin knew they would be okay. At night, her father sang her songs about his great adventures. He sang of giant leviathan serpents, haunted caves, and a lost city of gold beneath the sea. Merrin knew the stories weren't real, but she loved to listen to them. She drifted off to sleep, imagining the wonders of the world below. And her life continued that way, simply and happily. Until one night, her father didn't return. Merrin held up her candle at the cliff's edge all through the night, staring out at the empty sea. She shivered in the cold wind as she watched for him all the next day. Her eyes welled with tears as night fell again and there was still no sign of her father. At last, she collapsed into sleep. In her dreams, she saw him, trapped deep beneath the sea, calling to her for help. She awoke with a jolt. A desperate and dangerous plan was already forming in her head. She took scraps of metal and wood her father had caught in his nets and pieced them together. She hammered and bolted, she measured and sawed. And before the sun had set, she had built a tiny, rickety submarine.
You did that in a day? That's freaking impressive.
She dove down beneath the waves to search for her father.
All right, let's do this. Again, I know very little about this game, so this is a blind playthrough, as I've said. I will turn on the subtitles when I can. There's a loading bar down below, but you probably can't see it because the overlay. But it's loading. It does not look safe at all. Not at all. But hats off to her for entrepreneurship and craftiness, for sure. Okay. I am playing with a controller for what it's worth. It just seems to me Metroidvania type games tend to work for me better with a controller. Subtitles, yes. Thank you. Let's do that. Okay. So I don't know the controls. Left stick is definitely move around. That much I got. Right, going up doesn't seem to be feasible right now. What over there? No, the water current's too fast. We'll have to come back here later. Is there a map button currently? Yeah, there is. Okay. World progression! We've played for 1 minute. There we go. That's important. Alright, so it seems like no buttons right now other than start and map.
Shimmered with mystery. Glow kelp bulbs lit up around her as she passed by.
Yeah, some games just work really well with a controller. Razors for sure, but I don't tend to play Razors too often, so for me, that's less of an issue, I guess. That looks important, so I want to look up here. Where I will... Nope. I guess I'll just find that anyway. Is that like a mustache coin?
Some odd-looking old coins. Maybe her father would know where they were from.
It's a little crab. Can it hurt me? Can I hurt it? No. It's just kind of a crab down there, being crabby. Oh yeah, I always have a soft spot for Metroidvania games, specifically 2D ones. Just something I love. Scratches an old itch, I guess. They've been declining as of late, but they're clearly not gone. There's just less of them. Oh, look at those turtles back there. Look at the turtles! Kind of turtles? Turtle-ish type things. Oh, getting carried away. Let's try up here first. No, shoot, shoot, shoot. I want to get that coin. I want to get that. Oh, damn it. Okay. Not getting that coin. Fine. Let's progress forward. Get coins over this way. We will not. Maybe I need a tetanus shot? Metroidvania games are usually classified as games with a large map to explore, with many secret areas, usually involving you getting new upgrades and abilities that unlock new areas. It's named after Metroid games and Castlevania games, specifically Castlevania games after Symphony of the Night. Before that, they weren't that type of game per se. They were more of a platformer, which was also great, but it didn't quite fit the Metroidvania thing.
Her father once told her about a mysterious, living energy called Tyne. Could that have been a Tyne wellspring?
Correct. Ori and the Time of Blind Forest is definitely a Metroidvania-type game. Correct. Probably one of the better examples in recent date. So that's definitely a save point. Every time I pass it, it locks up a little bit and goes, it's saving now. Yeah, Ori did things a little differently than others, but it follows the basic idea of a Metroidvania, for sure. No, I don't want to go. Okay, this is clearly just me being bad at this. We got it. Only 6 gigabytes, yep. Oh no, that's the size on disk. That doesn't mean it's the install size, that's the size on the disk. It may still have updates or whatnot. Yeah. Yeah, Ori was a very well-made game. Did what it did very well. It was beautiful, had a great soundtrack.
Gears darted out of the way as Marin approached. She wondered who could have built such a curious creature.
Ori and the Stevie Wonder Forest. Not quite how I'd put it, but you know. If we can't make it through this to get that coin, hell yeah. Presumably, yeah, that counts for more. I'm just glad that No Man's Sky has gone gold. That's all that matters. It's done, effectively, for release purposes. Damn it, I keep getting caught in that one. Yeah, don't worry, I got the Stevie Wonder's Blind reference. Got that. I just, yeah. Ah, damn it, alright, I'll start over from the side. Screw it, that's what you want me to do, game. I see what you're doing. There we go. There we go. It is not Irish. This is actually Northern United States. The problem is right now I've bitten my tongue really hard at the convention, so I'm speaking weirdly. Unless you're talking about the game, in which case, yes, I am hearing a little bit of an Irish accent from the game. It's definitely got that feel to it. Or that sound to it? Magnetic Claw. Capable of grabbing, pulling, and attacking.
Aaron approached a glowing scrap of metal and pulled it inside. It was claw-shaped and had a strong magnetic pull. She took out her tools and attached it to a firing mechanism on her steering column.
I'm using X. Oh, they don't mean X. They mean the what X would be on an Xbox controller. Got it. It's not. I'm using a PS4 controller. I prefer it personally. Ah, okay, so we can use it as a weapon, too. Got it. I don't know why. The radio voice, yeah, which isn't really an accent per se, it's just kind of talking. I don't think these are useful for anything over here. Nope. Looks like they won't pass through there. Loot-based games. Oh, man, do I have a soft spot for loot-based, specifically loot-based action RPGs.
She had to be cautious, as the hostile creatures would attack her on
sight. Oh, wow, okay. Let's throw this at it. Oh, I missed. Didn't expect it to have that wide of a range. Where did he go? Did he run away? Cool. I like that. Yeah, loot-based games are always fun to me. Especially loot-based action RPGs, because you got the leveling, you got the looting, you got everything all working together in a nice way to do things. Oh man, Borderlands 3. I am excited. I know nothing about it, except they're working on it. And it doesn't matter. I'm excited. Alright, come on, you damn jellyfish of death. Well, I missed. Okay, these guys are... Can I just attack them? Yeah, okay. Throwing stuff works, but I can do this too. Yeah, love me some loot-based... Oh, that's gonna explode. Don't explode on me. 72 is a bit of an odd number, but that's just what they do, I guess. Uh-huh, I wonder if this goes over here. There we go. And a save point. Beautiful. Asleep. Claw. Meryn's path.
She knew it all too well from her father's stories. And she knew it must never be woken.
So we're gonna wake it, right? Like, first thing we're gonna do is wake it up. I like how she brought a little captain's hat with her. Yep. There we go. As a tutorial boss, I wouldn't expect him to be super challenging. Considering our only trick right now is throw bomb. Or throw something. No, go that way! Okay, well, I still ended up missing.
According to her father, the Guardians had been built by ancient undersea explorers called the Fomori. Meryn always thought the Fomori were a myth. Now she wondered if her father's other stories might be true.
I'm gonna see if I can turn up the in-game volume a little bit. No, not from here. Let me see if I can turn it up via my program. OBS. Because I feel like this deserves the sound being heard. Sounds really good. Don't know if that mattered much. Don't wake it up. Actually, yeah, wake it up. I mean, she knew it must never be woken up, but our options were that or don't progress, so I mean... Ooh, what's that? What do we have? No idea what that does. Well, we can grab it, though. Grab the coins. But yeah, I love me loot-based action RPGs. That's why you'll find me playing Path of Exile quite a bit, because it's fantastical at loot-based action RPGs, in my opinion. This swelling on the left-hand side of my tongue is really throwing me off, so that's the excuse I'm going to use anytime I flub words tonight. Yes, we need bombs. Probably some down here. Maybe. Possibly. Let's see. Don't know what those symbols are yet. Oh! Wells. Treasure. Ooh, we missed a treasure up there. Undying caves. Well, it's hard to kill a cave. Very hard, actually, I would think. Can we break this open by throwing it? Maybe it's a key.
Reminded her of her father's lullabies about the brave and beautiful marrows.
There we go. So just got to get it close. Which is good. Being accurate with that claw is not too easy. Save point. Claw also damages enemies. Thank you. I was hoping to have something to throw because they're just going to hurt me. Aw, yeah, she didn't look happy about that. Damn it. Alright, I should just charge them. Gonna take the hits anyway. So why not kill them faster? Trying to knock them away so I wouldn't get hit by their blast, but that ain't working well. Can we take the statue apart? Yes. Oh, crap! Oh, what the frick? Okay. Alright. You guys gotta stop that. And you have to go over there in a minute. There you go. Do they just keep spawning? There we go. Not that, at least. My health is dropping. I don't know how to get it back up, per se. I'm gonna die to basic jellyfish. I am going to die. Yep, there we go. Couldn't outmaneuver them. Recovering from a bad dream. For a moment, she thought she had experienced her own death. But it had merely been the time showing her one of the many possible roads ahead. That's one way of putting it, I guess. Don't die, you scrub, is what the game is pretty much telling me. I clearly need to get good. And if I'm gonna get hit, I may as well do as much damage as I can during it. So it looks like as soon as I pick this up is when more stuff spawns. There. Screw you. Screw you more. Screw you most. What, you got more, huh? Jellyfish are dangerous. Stop it. Oh, damn it. Alright, well, I already got hit anyway. Mostly healthy at the moment. Where's that head? No, really, where did the head go? No, seriously, where did the head go? I threw it pretty far. Not that. Get that out of here. It's probably right here, right? No? Yeah, threw it over this way, give or take. Shell. Is it really not around here? What the hell? I didn't throw it that far up. Do we hit this again? Yeah, we need bombs for that. Maybe the save point resets it. Negative. Alright. Think I broke the game. Or I'm just blind. 50-50. Could be either. If anybody happened to see where it went earlier when I was distracted with murdering things, feel free to let me know. That would be wonderful. But yeah, it usually shows that little green... It went all the way over there. Okay. Problem solved. My aim is terrible, but problem solved. Means we can go over this way too. Into all this loot. Loot, 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 loot.
As Marin explored, she sketched the terrain on a sheet of cartography paper. Her father had taught her that those who make maps are never lost.
Oh, look at all the eels. Okay, yeah, we got some treasure over there. Alright, not bad.
A huge
save point.
Crab
oh.
Watched Merin from a rocky ledge. On his back, he carried a vast array of odd-looking treasures. The crab
Let's
seemed
trade
like
with
shiny objects. Maybe he would be willing to make a trade.
So we can, with a little more, get our claw to do more damage. Extend the claw. Increase damage by reforging it into a more effective weapon. Increases the frequency of time drops. Excuse me. Lightning claw. I want that, but 2,000 coins. Hot damn. Magnet collector for 400. Tie-in recycler for 7. Repair bay for 1,000. And tie-in charger. So we can't really afford anything right now, but we're close. Oh, shoot! Oh, that's a one-way stream. Alright. Well, whatever. Let's roll with it. Shoot! Damn it! Stop it. Get away from me! No, don't shoot those! Man, these guys are brutal! Holy shit! These guys are really brutal! Which means, though, that I can try something besides up there for the moment. Definite dead end. Dead end, dead end. There's the head. Where's the statue to put it on, though? Ah, over there. I don't know if that'll work. Nope. Alright, I'll come back for that. But I can afford the upgrade, at least. Before we go over there.
Seem to like shiny objects. Maybe he would be willing to make a trade. Using the materials
there we go.
She bought from the hermit crab, Merrin took out her tools and made a quick modification to her magnetic claw.
Now it does more damage, because reasons. Because I am crafty, crafty lass. You best believe it. Okay, where's something to throw? Because they're coming at me. Ah, sweet! I can just one-shot jellyfish. That makes a huge difference. Like a really big difference. Okay. Things have gotten a bit easier now. That's the statue that needs a head. How about this? Does that count? Definitely? Yep, that definitely works. Aw, come on, let me get those. Ooh, okay. I'll wait. I'll do it the way you want me to, game. Not gonna make it! Not gonna make it! Let's try this again. Whee! Oh, so close! There we go. Got ourselves a head. Gonna do some stuff with it. Should have known that was what was going to happen.
Giant clams were notoriously picky eaters. Each one seemed to prefer a different kind of treat.
So he wants something specific. And yes, Pokemon Go has become crazy popular, and I'm so happy. People are meeting each other randomly on the streets like, oh yeah, Pokemon! That would be the treat the guy wants, I assume. Don't do it, bro! He just died somehow. I'm okay with that. It's amazing, actually. The effect Pokemon... That's really not the treat you want, you picky bastard. Alright, what do you want then? Try one of these guys. It's so big, and it's great. I love it. There you go. No. I'd like to throw you into it. Come on. Simple idea. Let me do it. Maybe if I throw it better? It seems like this isn't what he wants, though. No, it's not. Okay. Hell yeah. I took a gym earlier. It's already been taken back, but it was a really awesome experience doing it. Me and a guy I'd never met before were just in the area. We beat up a gym. It's a really powerful gym, too. I don't know how the hell they got 1,200 power Vaporeon already, but they did. And it was kind of crazy. Shit, I left the head over there, didn't I? I left the head over there. Yep. Okay, well, we'll go back for that. Got some exploring to do. Oh, damn it. Okay. That guy's gonna want that treat. Let's go back through here. Okay. It is a lot of fun. Pokemon Go is pretty much, other than the fact that you can't trade or battle with people, pretty much exactly what I and most people seem to have been looking for. No, let me go, let me go, let me go! Okay. You, sir, go that way. You, sir, also go this way, along with me. And we pop you into a clam. Which I'm sure is... It'll be fine. It'll be fine. Really? It's not it? You are a picky piece of garbage. You know that? Alright. Though, Sor, now I have to ask, what team are you on? Because that's an important question. I'm going to guess Mystic, because, like, everyone's Mystic. Alright, that opened up some coins, I guess. Ah, a new thing! Boost Jet! For getting through all those currents, I imagine.
Lay an undamaged propulsion device. Merrin bolted it onto the back of her submarine, eager to test out its...
Yeah, it does only work for a little while. But it keeps you going through those. It's a very short burst. Yeah, that's true. People do need to buy Sun and Moon. I mean, I understand that. I don't know why everyone's Mystic. Everyone's either red or blue, honestly. Very few people are yellow. I went Valor just because I liked it. There's no real reason. Just wanted to. A lot of people went Mystic, which is cool. Not many people went, what is it? I don't even remember the name of Yellow because there's so few people who actually did it. Oh, stop it. Don't you guys respawn on me now. That's true. I can see why they wanted to make sure people still got Sun and Moon, and I will still get Sun and Moon, for sure. I understand where they're coming from, I guess. You're gonna go Instinct, okay. That's the yellow one. Instinct, got it. So now that we have this, we should be able to go down here. Zapdos is cool, won't dispute. All three of the birds are cool. Honestly, I prefer Articuno as a bird. You won't be getting Sun and Moon. Alright. To each their own. I think they look pretty cool. So we can super throw while boosting. There. Beautiful. Didn't get all the coins, but got enough.
Father's songs. These were the lost ruins of the Marrows.
Yeah, I like the way that Sun and Moon are looking, but if you don't want to get it, don't get it. Plenty of other games to play. That is for sure. Man, jellyfish everywhere, though. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. Merrin's path.
Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, were very shy, and even avoided each other's light.
Ah, okay. Light puzzle. Got it. Let's find some light. Team Valor, hell yeah! Team Valor is best team. It's well known. I don't think this is gonna make light, but I'm still gonna try it anyway. Hyah! Nope. Alright, well, I'm probably gonna need that later. Yeah, Valor is a cool team. I like it. But most people seem to have gone either Valor or Mystic. There's no real... Ow! Don't do that! Why the f... Okay. Ow! Like, super ow! Let the health come back a little ways. It probably only comes back to a point, I believe, though. Try boosting when that happens. Much better. Whee!
Merrin peered through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there, and if her father had sung her lullabies about the world above.
So we got a cannon shooting at us. We need light. That's a bomb. I assume we'll work on that. Hey, explode please, thank you. Maybe? That not work? Okay. Try again. You could, please make me another bomb? Ah, no! Crap, okay. Ow. Ah, dead. And it does regen to full, it does look like it. Oh, did I not touch a save point since here? Okay. It's over this way anyway. Two walls I can't get through yet. Alright. What are you? Ah, you're more coins. Okay. Down we go. Oh, it didn't save this? Bullcrap. Guess I just didn't touch any save points during the time. Go, fly, be free! Technically didn't really make it very far anyway. There, we'll hit this save point.
She knew this place from her father's songs. These were the lost ruins of the Merrows.
Yeah, I doubt that's a light too, honestly. I said light. Nope. Just mildly annoying them. Okay. Hey, Mr. Cannon guy, eat a dick. Stop shooting at me. I said, stop shooting at me. Really? That's not gonna do it? Okay, it won't even get any closer than that. Maybe the bigger one will do it. How the hell did it spawn a bigger one earlier? There's the bigger one. Okay, this had better do it. Nope. Okay. Got it. That's not the answer. Sweet save point. Oh, crap. All right. Okay. You need to stop that. And I need to boost on through there. Whee! It's a weak pounding you got there. Search lights. Ah, well, there you go. Got lights. Hope those are just automatic.
Glowing lights amidst the scraps of an old Fomori machine. She attached them to the front of the submarine's hull, hoping they would help guide her on her journey.
Yeah. I don't see any reason to turn them off at this point. They don't seem to be wasting electricity. Okay, fine. I guess I got hurt there. We got lights!
Color darted through the shadows.
Oh.
Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins?
A Merrow maiden. Not a mermaid. A Merrow maiden. Very different. Totally different. Don't get them confused. Ow. I am a pro dodger. Don't even insinuate otherwise. You'll be wrong. I am nothing but a pro at this. Totally. Okay, not quite. The hell was that? Some sort of audible. Oh. Okay. Why did that spawn there and give me 50? I didn't do anything. I'm okay with it. I'm just confused. I assume the cannon is still cannoning. Sounds like it.
Merrin peered through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there.
So there's definitely a pearl down there.
Her lullabies about the world.
Don't know how to get it though. So we'll go over this way, where we know there's stuff we gotta do.
Merrin tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away.
Okay, they just move aside for her, that's fine. That's cool. That's great. And Mr. Jellies, if you could move out my way, that would be wonderful. I guess that's not what he wants either. Wrong color, right? Oh shoot! That was actually it! I'm honestly surprised at that. Didn't fit the color at all. Aha! I just punched the walls. Take that, everything. Alright, not quite punchable enough for those yet. I tend to agree. Sun and Moon don't look bad to me, but different people like different things. I'm excited, but I'm always excited to play a new Pokemon game. It's not news. I've played one game in every generation. It's not going to stop now. Yeah, my end game for X and Y was just shiny hunting. I hunted a ton of shinies. But you're right, it wasn't the strongest end game. Still, I did get a ton of shinies, and that was pretty awesome. Battle Mansion was okay. It wasn't great.
In the water tugged at Merrin's sob. Was this a Tyne vortex? Where am I?
Clearly, we gotta go into there. After breaking all this valuable potteries. Oh, okay, we have to actually hit a button to warp. But first, how about you?
At last,
what do you got to say?
A Merrow maiden stopped. Merrin called to her. Please wait. I'm only trying to find my father. The Merrow looked at her for a long moment, then stirred the water with her hands, forming a ghostly image. It was the sunken ship graveyard known as Skeleton Reef. Could her father be trapped there? The Merrow pointed the way to go, and Merrin thanked her.
I actually didn't really play much of the Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire.
Turned to go, Merrin asked the Merrow her name.
Call me Car, she said. Another girl once called me that, years ago. She said it means friend.
I didn't play much of the Omega Ruby and Sapphire. I probably should have. I got disheartened because I lost all of my shiny Pokemon when I transferred to my new 3DS, and it was just disheartening. All those Pokemon gone. So I was a little not in the mood to play at that rate. Why would I toggle the searchlight off?
To reach the lost graveyard of ships, Merrin would have to cross the foul and treacherous region known as Watcher's Hollow. This was a place her father had never sung about, for the tales of the Watcher were known only to those below.
Ooh, so we're getting to dangerous territory. 250 for a longer claw. Oh, better boost. I think I might do the better boost for now. I had X and Y digital. That was the problem. I had X and Y digitally. I have Omega Ruby physical. When I went to go transfer it over, for whatever reason, none of my save files transferred, which sucks. So they're all gone. All of my fantastic Pokemons, all dust in the wind. Yeah, it was not my favorite moment. Hey, we got loot. What is it? Oh, maximum health. Hell yeah. Yeah, I had a lot of stuff.
She hammered it into the wall of her own submarine, making it more resistant to damage.
I am very curious. Is that a fucking narwhal? I'm curious how she's upgrading her ship while underwater. That's some real impressive craftsmanship, honestly. Yeah, I should have known. I should have had a physical copy. Or I should have just gotten the Pokebank and done that. But no, I was like, that's fine. I'll be fine. I wasn't fine. But I'll play Sun and Moon, and I'll enjoy those. It's been long enough now that I can recover. Oh, that's cool. That's like an anchor point. Yeah. I like that idea. No, didn't reach the next anchor point. Alright, let's do this. We got this. Woo! Damn it! Oh, okay, I got it. Now I've learned. Now I won't get Pokemon games digitally. That was a mistake you make once and only once. So I've learned that one now. Still... No. Forward, ho. I don't think this is gonna work. At all, no. Nope, I ain't making it there. Alright, turning around then. Yeah, I hatched a legit shiny Charmander back in Black 2. And I transferred it to X and Y, because fucking Black Charizard is amazing looking. And it's gone. I did a lot of my endgame in X and Y was shiny hunting, so I did a lot of friend safaris. Oh, one of my real life friends did complete her Pokedex, and she got the shiny, so now she can go shiny hunting and be way better at it than I was. I never did the full Pokedex. It's too many Pokemon for me. Clearly not impossible, but... What is this? It's a bed. Is it bad? I bet you have to get close to it with something and it'll open this door. Seems to be sending out a ping. I bet you if I let it ping whatever it's looking for, it'll work fine. Eventually. This is probably a dead end for now. I was clearly supposed to go through the caves.
She was poking at a glass wall.
Oh.
Such a strange creature, Merin thought. She wished she could understand what it wanted.
Clearly to go through the glass wall, but I don't seem to be able to do that right now. So we're going back up. And back to the creepy looking cave we go. Did that already? We save. And we carry on. So I probably won't be carrying on for too much longer. I am very tired right now. Khan is definitely caught up to me for reals. Good, I can't get stuck on the web. I'll probably do a little exploring in this area, find a save point, and call it for now. Not the longest stream I've ever done. But hey, will that hurt me? Probably. Yeah, of course it will. Oh shit, does that hurt me? Wow. That wasn't like a little bit of pain, that was massive death. Bet you they pull away from the light, maybe. Maybe? No, doubt it. Oh, they're just death on the walls, okay. Let's be a little more careful. I had to test it, I mean, you had to check. Oh boy. But like, two-shot death? That's pretty crazy. Wow, look at that shit over there. Which means there's gotta be a way to get rid of them. If they're all covering something. Cool, you dropped an item. 10 gold coins, that's wonderful. Oh, damn it, no, shit. That really hurts. Really hurts. Yeah, you're a bad guy. You're... not? What does this guy do? Oh, he doesn't hurt me. Oh, okay. Caverns, heedless of their deadly surroundings. Maybe they were tough enough. Gotta follow him. Even the stinging anemones seemed to avoid them. Okay. That's cool. Man, look at all that loot down there. I'll have to go back for that shit. Thanks, guy. That was awesome. You led me through. Is that a chest of some sort? Maybe. Nothing I can do with it yet. I think, actually, I'm really fading fast. I think I'm going to take this save point here and call it for now. Yes, it was only an hour of this game, and I do apologize for that. I just really hitting my wall fast tonight, so sorry. Just the way it's going. This has been... What the hell is the name of this game again? Song of the Deep, there we go. This has been Song of the Deep. I have been Viperass for Viperland. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed it. I will be playing more of this after work tomorrow. I very much enjoyed what I was just playing. I'm just, very tired. Very, very tired. So, there will be more of this tomorrow. Hope you guys enjoyed. Look forward to more. And definitely look forward to, I don't know, roughly 48 hours from now. When Pokemon Go, holy shit. When Monster Hunter Generations is of a game of choice. Till then, this has been Viperass for Viperland, and tune in next time.